that the shed needs to be smaller than the opening on the gates. Please reference our report for the details. If we look at the lock and the logo and the lock opening button, this would be the top of our lock. If we turn the lock down and look at the combination set screw, at the top of the lock is where we'll insert our shim. We insert our shim while we apply pressure and rotate the wheels until we feel the shim enter the gates. We do this until the shim inserts all four of the gates in each of the wheel packs. Applying pressure, turning the wheel, and finding the combination. And there we have it. Our shim has now entered the lock and decoded the lock. If we pull the shim out, we see that the length of the shim was reached through all the gates and all the wheel packs. If we look, our combination 0, 1, 6, 4 will not open the lock. And the reason is we need to move the gate from the top of the lock over to the top of the set screw to change combination. And we do this by reducing the combination by 3. Very simple, very trivial bypass. This lock is not secure, it's not considered safe, it should not be used.